President Museveni has vowed to crush increasing criminality in areas of Kampala following an attack on General Wamala Katumba. While delivering the State of Nation address, Museveni blasted police for failure to utilize security cameras to cap down crime. Museveni has also slammed India for denying Uganda COVID-19 vaccines. Take a look.
In fulfillment of the constitutional requirement under Article 101, Clause 1 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, I am here to deliver the State of the Nation Address 2021.
In his State of the Nation Address of the sixth term in office, which has been hosted at Kola Independence Grounds, President Yoweri Museveni vowed to defeat increasing cases of criminality following the attacks on the former UPDF chief, General Katumba Wamala, where his daughter and driver lost their lives.
We are expanding the brigades of 3rd Division and 1st Division. The criminality around Kampala was defeated and is being defeated. The only element to get rid of is the corruption and poor procedures within the police. NRM people were reporting intimidation and harassment by terrorists at the police post. These good-for-nothing characters would tell them that there is no political desk. If you do not have a desk for terrorism in your police post, you will go home and somebody else will do the job.
He revealed that investigations into Katumba shooting are progressing well, and one of the guns which were used has been identified to be one of those which were used in the murder of Major Muhammad Chigundu, who was gunned down in November 2016 in Masanafu, a Kampala suburb.
The gun which was used is already identified, which was used in the case of the Katumba attack. It is the same one which was used in the Chigundu case. Chigundu, the Major Chigundu. And a number of those, not all of them, were arrested, but they were released by the courts on bail. Why somebody who has killed people should be released on bail, I cannot understand.
Museveni blasted police for failure to make use of security cameras to fight crime, yet they cost government over 400 billion shillings.
The cameras I put in place did their work. As you saw, the killers were running from one area to another area. Why didn't the camera center alert all the patrol cars and even the UAVs? UAVs are these unmanned air vehicles. We have them. They can follow you anywhere once they are deployed to chase and block these killers. No, these wonderful camera managers think that their gadgets are only for storing videos for forensic analysis as part of the postmortem of the operation. Yes. The cameras are for forensic, but also for enduro.
He has now ordered police to step up their work and stop using mobile phones to investigate crimes, but go back to radio calls which communicate to several correspondents at a go. He also directed police to implement digital monitors on motor vehicles.
Stop using mobile phones and go back to using radios that are open to all stations so that they can act promptly in emergencies like the one of General Katumba. In addition to the cameras, our security leaders have been working on my directive of installing digital monitors. This was part of the 12 points, to have a digital monitor in every vehicle, every piki-piki, so that wherever you are, the command post can know.
On COVID-19 pandemic, Museveni slammed the government of India for denying Uganda AstraZeneca vaccine as they move to protect their citizens battling with the deadly wave of the pandemic.
With the vaccination, we recently hit a snag when, on account of the very bad situation that developed in India, that country stopped the fresh exports of the vaccine. My advice to the countries that are producing vaccines now is to be careful with this point.
However, he assured Ugandans that local scientists are in advanced stages to produce the cure and vaccine for COVID-19 locally.
Making a vaccine involves 9 or 8 phases. If WHO allows you to skip one phase, our researchers are now entering stage 4. I congratulate them. We hope to get to stage 8 by November 2021. I can assure Uganda that by the end of 2021, we shall no longer be waiting for outsiders to rescue us.
Museveni explained the economic viability of the parish development model and why it's the best alternative to drive the socio-economic transformation of the people.
I strongly urge our people to join the 4 sectors: commercial agriculture, industries, services, and ICT. With commercial agriculture, we are emphasizing the parish model. At the parish, you are able to know all the homesteads. Because when you are sub-county constituency is too far, you may not know all the homesteads.
He pledged to facilitate industrialization in his new term by reducing the interest rates and power tariffs. The president reported slow growth of the economy at 3%, which he attributed to COVID-19. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.